Hi, this is Sabrina from A Space to Create Art, and today we're going to talk about pointillism.
Okay, today we're going to talk about pointillism practice. And pointillism was a method by which artists created shading and value using dots. In drawing, we use a technique that's similar. It's called stippling. And it's similar because it's a series of dots. The smaller they are and the wider they're spaced, the lighter they appear. The bigger they are and the closer they are spaced, the darker they appear. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take you through this worksheet to kind of show you how you create value using dots or pointillism. And then we're going to do the same thing with one color. And then we're also going to do it with multiple colors. And then we're going to apply it to a project, which should be fun. So when you're doing a value scale, it's always light to dark or white to black. You always want to leave white and you want to have a black. So we're going to start by doing some small dots, widely spaced, to create the first value or the lightest value. And then I'm going to create the same size dots, but more closely spaced to create the next value. Value is another word for shading, light to dark and all the values in between. And shading is what transforms something from a flat shape to a three-dimensional object like a sphere. So when we're done shading this value scale, we're going to shade the circle and make it appear to be a three-dimensional sphere. So what I want to do is I try to make it go darker as it goes up the scale. So for my next one, I'm going to create slightly larger dots. And I'm going to let them overlap even a little bit more to create even darker shade. And then I'm going to do even bigger dots. And I'm just creating bigger dots by letting the pen sit on the page a little bit longer. So you can see it's getting darker as it goes. Scale now from light to dark. I just filled in the black one with a thick Sharpie, and now I just wanted to give you an idea of how to shade a sphere using this same technique. I'm going to pretend the light source is coming from over here, so it's going to be darkest on the left hand side. And so I'm just going to start by doing my dots bigger and more closely set, and you can layer these dots. So I'm going to put down a basic, and then I'm going to come back and I'm going to go over this even more with like the next size dot. Always want to follow the contour of the object, and the contour is the shape, the line that defines the edge of the object. So in a sphere, it's round. So you never want to shade straight or straight across. You always want to shade in a circular pattern. And in the shadow is darkest right underneath the object. And then it kind of gets lighter as it goes out. It doesn't get a lot lighter, but it does get slightly lighter as it gets further away from the object.
Ink.
creating value with ink. Next, we're going to go to creating value using the stippling technique with one color, and I am going to use red. So again, white, and when you're using color pencil, you have to kind of take a minute and set down the dots. I'm going to keep going, and I'm just going to speed up the video here, you guys, so you will see this all finished here in a second. So that's the value scale, light to dark, and then we're going to shade our sphere. And remember, when we're doing our darkest value, you're going to use larger dots and overlap them a little bit. And you're also going to follow the contour of your object. Next, we're going to do colored pencil, but we are going to use more than one color to create the value scale. And what I want you to do is think about what your final art is going to be, what the main color of that final art will be, and then try to use that same color scheme in order to create this as a practice. So I'm going to do a royal angelfish, and that mostly has the main part of its body is oranges and yellows. So I'm going to go ahead and go with red, yellow, and orange to create my value scale here at the bottom. So color has value. When you're looking at these three colors, obviously the lightest color is yellow, and then orange, and then red. So you want to use that to your advantage. So for my lightest values, I'm going to use my yellow. And I'm going to create some dots using the same method. Smaller dots, more widely spaced, but this time they're going to be in yellow. Okay. Then I'm going to go to my second box, and I'm going to start by laying down some yellow again. I'm going to lay down a little bit of orange as well, to create that next level of value or shading. Okay, then I'm gonna go to orange, but bigger orange dots and closer together. And I'm gonna take my yellow and just fill in with some yellow as well. When you're doing a value scale, you want it to try to be gradual from light to dark. The more shades that you can get into your art, the more three-dimensional and more realistic it's going to look. Okay. Laying down my orange. Okay, next I'm going to start by laying down my orange again. But this time I'm going to add red to it. I think this is where it gets fun. I think pointillism is meant to be used with color. Otherwise, it's mostly just stippling, which is a drawing technique, but it's good to start there because it's good to understand how to create the shades and how to make it lighter and darker. Okay, now I'm gonna take some red. Down the red with bigger dots. Okay, so there we have gone from yellow to red. With orange in the middle, and we've created a value scale from light to dark. And what you're going to do is you're going to do the same thing on your sphere, creating the same light source. So the lightest color is going to be yellow. A shaded sphere using pointillism and using color to do the shading, yellow, orange, and red.
This is Sabrina from A Space to Create Art. Have fun creating.